Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have studied what is Faraday's law, and based on that we have studied Faraday's first law and second law, and we have also formulated a formula where we could estimate what would be the weight of the particular substance that could deposit when this much or a particular amount of current is passed through the solution at a particular time. So now let us do the numerical based on that equation. So above mentioned question relates the Faraday's first law and Faraday's second law, in which what we have to calculate is, we have to calculate the mass of the copper metal produced during passage of 5 ampere of current through the copper sulfate solution for 100 minutes. The molar mass of copper was found to be 63.5 gram per mole. So in this case, the first thing that we should do is we should extract the data from the given question. And the given question says, and we have a data when 5 ampere of current is passed. So therefore, current is denoted by I. Therefore, I is equals to 5 ampere. The next is, they have mentioned time. And in this case, the time is 100 minutes. So whenever the time is being mentioned, so the first thing that you should do is you should convert it into seconds. So what I'm going to do is 100 into 60 seconds. So this will be giving me an answer like 6000 seconds. And the next thing which is much more important, that is molar mass of copper is being provided to us. So therefore, molar mass of copper, that is Cu, they have provided us as 63.5 gram per mole. And the formula that we have is the common formula, that is W is equals to ZIT divided by 96500. So this is the formula that we have got, and we have to estimate the mass, that we have to estimate the weight of the copper that has been deposited. So the value of I is known to us, the value of T is known to us, but this value of Z, that is equivalent weight, is not known to us. So how can we calculate this thing? So let us see it now. So Z, let me tell you, the Z, which means equivalent weight, is nothing but molecular weight divided by valency of the metal in ionic form. So the solution that has been provided to us is copper sulfate solution. So when you dissociate, or when the dissociation of copper sulfate occurs, it is converted into Cu2 plus SO4 2 minus. So because of which, the molecular weight that has been given to us as 63.5, but the valency of the metal in ionic form, here you can see the oxidation number as 2. So because of help of this, we could estimate the value of Z, that is equivalent weight. So therefore, the molecular weight, which is given as 63.5, divided by the valency of metal in ionic form, in this case is 2 plus, so I will divide it by 2. So therefore, the answer that I could get is 31.75. So this is the value of equivalent weight that we have got. And again, it is molecular weight. The molecular weight is has a unit of gram per mole. So similarly, the equivalent weight of Z will also be gram per mole, and since it is divided by the valency, so valency is just a number. So we have got the value of Z, and now we have can easily calculate what would be the value of W, that is the value of weight. So therefore, W is equals to ZIT divided by 96500. In this case, the value of Z, that is the value of equivalent weight that we have got, is 31.75, and then that of the current that they have provided to us was 5 ampere, and the time that we have been calculated, and it was provided in minutes, but we have converted into seconds, which was found to be 6000 divided by 96500. So this means the answer that we could get is 9.870. But the unit of the weight in this case will be gram. Because this kind of experiment is being done, and the unit that is being taken, that we have taken the unit of time which was present in minute, we have taken the time in seconds, and we have taken the molecular weight in gram per mole. So therefore the answer that we have got now will be in the unit of gram. So this is how we have calculated the weight of a particular substance, and in this case of a particular copper, when present in a copper sulfate solution and electrolysis has happened. So how many amount of copper has been deposited on a particular electrode? So this was very much easy, which was based on Faraday's first law. So thank you friends for watching this video. We are going to take the next video too. So please share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.